Hello guys, my name is Atiyah JT, and today I will show you how the board examinations are conducted in the Philippines during the pandemic.
Before I begin, make sure to subscribe and press the notification bell.
For those who don't know, I am a graduate of Bachelor of Science in Geology degree from Partido State University in the Bicol region. The COVID-19 pandemic resulted to the cancellation of so many events, including my graduation from the university and the 2020 Geologist Licensure Examinations, which was supposed to happen last November 2020. During the lockdown, I preferred to stay in Bicol since the COVID-19 cases there are low to non-existent. From March to December 2020, I stayed inside my friend's house and started reading geology books and studied hard. I wasn't able to attend the CWM Zenana review scheduled for July last year because it will be conducted via Zoom, and I thought that it's better for me to self-review than to spend money for lectures that will be conducted online. I relied on my slides, PDFs, and questionnaires that I downloaded from the internet. The flashcards from Quizlet.com also helped me a lot. I also purchased a reviewer from MGC made by top-notchers from Adamson University for only 300 pesos. This was my daily routine for several months, but I got bored easily once the PRC announces that all board exams for 2020 will be cancelled. Fast forward to November 2020, PRC released a brand new schedule, and the geologist licensure examination was scheduled for February 16 to 18, 2021. It reignited my will to study hard, and by November 24, 2020, I started to file for the examination. I began by compiling all of the requirements: Bachelor of Science in Geology degree, Bachelor of Science in Geological Engineering degree, or a Master of Science in Geology degree. Transcript of records with for board examination purposes remarks, PSA birth certificate, PSA marriage contract for married female applicants, payment of 900 pesos with receipt, passport size ID with name tag, long brown envelope, and documentary stamps. Then, I set up an appointment with PRC and found an available schedule at Robinson's Place, Naga. There were only a few people inside their office, and my application only took 45 minutes to complete, including the time spent on the queue. After my application has been verified, PRC Naga handed over my notice of admission, and this is a very important document that you should keep. By December 2020, I had to say goodbye to my friends in Bicol and return to Manila to spend the holidays with my family. I started to study again after the holidays and focus on the files that I have on my computer, along with a reviewer that I purchased from MGC. What I did was to answer as many questionnaires as I can and averaging my scores to see if it will reach 70%. To pass the geologist licensure examinations, one needs to get a total average of 70%. The exams are conducted in 3 consecutive days, covering 3 subjects. The subject on the first day is general geology, and its weight is 40%. The subject on the second day is petrology and mineralogy, and on the third day, it's applied geology. Each has a 30% weight. You should not get a score lower than 15 these days, because if you do, no matter how high your scores in other subjects will be, you will still be given a failing grade. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic, the PRC required examinees to bring additional documents on the day of the exam. These are the things that you should bring on the first day of your exams: notice of admission with receipt, RT-PCR test results 3 to 5 days before the exam date if you are a suspected COVID-19 case, an individual with relevant history of travel and exposure, or a healthcare worker. If you do not fall in the categories previously stated, a certificate of quarantine signed by a municipal health official, barangay health official, or a licensed physician will suffice. I got mine from Barangay San Juan in Taytay, Rizal, and I would like to give Ma'am Irma a shout out for assisting me to get this document. You would also need to print and fill out annexes A and B, which can be downloaded from the PRC website as an attachment to Memorandum Number 68. You also need to bring passport-size ID photos on the day of the examinations. To prevent the spread of disease, a face mask, face shield, and 70% ethyl alcohol is also required. In addition, black ball pens, number 2 Mongol pencils, sharpener, one long plastic envelope, and one long brown envelope are also needed. For those who are taking the licensure examinations for geologists, you will be required to bring your hand lens, strict plate, magnets, and all other tools for rock and mineral identification on the second day. On the third day, non-programmable calculators, rulers, and protractors will be required. You also need to bring your meals and wallets. Another requirement stated on the memorandum released by the Board of Geology is a one-piece metered stamp window mailing envelope, but when I asked PRC about it, they told me that it can be purchased on the day of the examinations. For those who will be taking the licensure examination for geologists, I highly suggest reading these books: Earth Science by Tarbak, Historical Geology by Weekender, Fundamentals of Geomorphology by Haggett, Geology of the Philippines and Lexicon of Philippine Stratigraphy by Peña, Minerals of the Philippines by the Mines and Geosciences Bureau, Manual of Mineralogy by Dana, Earth Materials by Heffernan and O'Brien, Optical Mineralogy by Kerr, Petrology of Igneous and Metamorphic Rocks by Winter, all articles in Alex Trikinson website, all articles about geology in Tulane University website, all mining, resource, and environmental laws, including RA 10166, RA 4209, PMRC, Code of Ethics, and History of the Geological Society of the Philippines, and finally, slides, books, or articles about petroleum and coal. In addition, make sure to read and answer all of the questionnaires that you can find in Quizlet.com and the entire internet. I only type in geology exam questions in the search bar and it will give me a lot of questions to answer. When using Quizlet, you can choose to display the questions as a flashcard or as a multiple choice question, and playing the games all day will make learning easier. Make sure that you also read a lot of trivia about geology, geography, astronomy, and current events.
Today is February 16, 2021, Tuesday, at ngayon yung unang araw ng board exam ko. So, pupunta kami ng Sampaloc, Manila ng 4:45 a.m. And yung unang subject namin for today ay General Geology. So, wish me luck!
I wasn't able to sleep on the first day of our examinations because of excitement. I live in Taytay, Rizal, and the examination site is in Sampaloc, Manila. So we have to leave home at 4:45 in the morning to get there before 6:30 a.m. The distance is around 20 kilometers, and our travel time was less than an hour. As we arrived on the gate of the school where the exams will be held, sellers started offering us the last requirement that I still don't have: that one-piece metered stamp window mailing envelope with documentary stamps. They sell it for 100 pesos, so I purchased one. Before we can enter our rooms, our temperatures had to be checked, and our hands need to be sanitized. The proctor came in exactly at 6:30 a.m., and we were instructed to fill out the identification sheet. We were told that only black ball pens should be used. By 8 a.m., the questions arrived. I finished answering the 100-item exam by 9:15 a.m. and decided to go home early.
Ayan guys, so kakauwi ko lang galing dun sa venue namin sa Holy Trinity Academy sa Sampaloc, Manila. And sobrang antok ko dahil wala nga akong tulog kagabi, no? And hindi na tayo nakapag-video kasi bawal naman talagang mag-video dun sa loob ng testing site. So bukas is second day na natin sa board exam and petrology and mineralogy naman yung subject natin. So ngayon is general geology and tapos na siya and thankful ako dahil yung mga inaral ko talaga is lumabas siya dun sa board exam. So hopefully ganun din bukas. So tulog muna ako ha.
On the second day of our examinations, the proctor started giving us our test papers at exactly 8 a.m. The questions were more difficult than yesterday. Today, even if you finished early, you still had to wait for your room's turn because 10 items on the exam will be for rock and mineral identification. It was already 10 a.m. when we were told to go to the gymnasium to identify 10 rocks and minerals. You should bring your tools for mineral identification on this day because it will be a huge help identifying what's on the table. After finishing the last 10 items, I submitted my paper and went home.
Hi guys, so today is the last day of my exams and ang subject namin today is applied geology. So ready na tayong pumunta sa Manila for our last hurrah. So good luck sa akin and good luck sa lahat ng nag-take. We're on our way to Sampaloc. Ayan, leaving Taytay at 5 a.m. Traffic buildup here in Rosario. Ayan, Daddy, anong message mo sa akin? Last day na ngayon ng exam.
Oh, Kuya TJ, last day mo na ngayon. Good luck. Sana mag-pray ka na pumasa ka sa board exam mo. Good luck, Kuya.
Okay, thank you, Daddy. Yan, so tara na po, baba na tayo. Okay, so last day na po ngayon ng exam. And nandito na si Edmarie Amata. Nauna na siya. So ano masasabi mo sa boards?
Kaya.
Kaya. Sarado pa eh, no? Sarado pa po yung venue yan. May gate pa. Kasi alas 7 pa pero alas 6 pa lang.
Alas 8 ang start eh.
So, anong message mo sa lahat ng takers?
We're all pass.
So, huling araw na namin. Huling araw na. Excited, Ed? Excited ka sumagot? So, ngayon may pandemic, ganito mag-board exam. Ay, alcohol pa lang. Ayan. So, kailangan mag...
Normal temperature.
Oops.
Normal temperature.
Halos, Ed, mabagsak ko pa yung
thermometer. On the third day of our examinations, we were required to bring a ruler and a protractor. I did not bring any of it and just relied on my non-programmable calculator. The third day of our exam was very difficult, and more than 20% of the exam requires computation. It took me 3 hours to finish the exam, and before you can leave the room, the proctor will remind you to answer Annex C from the PRC Memorandum 68 and submit it by March 2, 2021. This is the health survey. After I got home, I prayed fervently for God to let me pass.
Hi guys, so nakauwi na ako sa bahay and tapos na yung third day ng exams. And ngayon, ang gagawin natin ay maghintay ng 2 to 3 days para sa result. So excited na akong malaman na may halong kaba din. So abangan natin yan sa mga susunod na araw.
By Monday, I decided to visit Robinson's Galleria because I felt nervous about the result of the board exams. Around 5 p.m., the results were released. This is the exact moment when I found out the results.
I passed.
And yes, I was able to pass the February 2021 Geologist Licensure Examinations. I was so happy with the results and immediately called my family to tell them about the news. It was a relief knowing that I will be having my license to practice my profession soon. Now that I am a licensed geologist, I am planning to work either for the government or a private mining company. But what I really wanted is to become a volcanologist for FIVOX. So I'll try sending as many applications as I can to the institute. For those who are watching this video, make sure to compile all of the requirements before your scheduled board exams. Remember to study smart and at the same time, pray for God's miracle and have faith that you will pass. Good luck to future board examinees, and hopefully, you learned a lot from this video. If you love this content, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Thank you!